The story of Dinkytown begins in the late 1800s as the University of Minnesota was becoming a very formidable institution that needed a front door, so to speak, a gateway. University Avenue was in place as a major thoroughfare, and the horse cars that served as the mass transit at the time were already operating. The area that we know as Dinkytown was about to become the university's own downtown. In 1905, the H.W. Wilson Company built the first large-scale commercial building in Dinkytown, and the rush was on. By the 1950s, Dinkytown was fully formed, pretty much as it is today. It had a two-story Dayton store bringing the latest fashions to the campus and all the other requisite businesses. But by the late 50s, the times, they were a-changing.
How many roads must a man walk down?
In the fall of 1959, Robert Zimmerman arrived in Dinkytown and began playing at the Scholar Coffee House along with John Kerner and others. Less than 2 years later, the transformation was nearly complete, and Bob Dylan and Kerner Rain Glover carried the Dinkytown culture to the rest of the world. Throughout the 60s and early 70s, Dinkytown culture was thriving. The Minnesota Dance Theater and The Loft were taking dance and literature to new heights, but then the bottom fell out. As both those institutions left Dinkytown to find new homes, the Phoenix tried to rise from the ashes, but Dinkytown was under siege. Today, much of the historic Dinkytown is still present. The gateway is still there, but now it's more like a back door into the campus. Downtown Minneapolis is still on the western horizon across the Mississippi and not easily accessible. So Dinkytown is still a major commercial center for the university, and the demand is growing for more student housing and commercial development. Just a quick glimpse down 14th Avenue reveals some major significant recent changes. A closer look shows that the House of Hanson, the Book House, the Podium, and the old Marshall U High are gone, replaced by new structures. Down 4th Street, a new high-rise and a crane in the western sky, bringing more. Some of the changes are less obvious. The Scholar has been gone for decades, and we're now on the third generation of changes on that site. But Dinkytown abides. It's still full of vitality. A look from the past. Yes, but still the present. Vecchio's still the same since 1956. Al's Breakfast still intact. The Espresso Royale building being well maintained. At 4th Street, the past is still the present, except that the Loring Pasta Bar has taken over the old Grodnick and Gray's Drugs. Down the block, much is still the same. Around the corner, Dinkydale is timeless with the Book House as a new tenant. And the Varsity Theater is perhaps even better than it ever was. 1 month ago, in late October, the first major meeting of Preserve Historic Dinkytown took place at the Loring Pasta Bar. The key members of the organization were there, as well as individuals who wanted to tell their stories and help to find ways to preserve the history of one of the most important areas in the entire state of Minnesota.
The gathering place over the cafe.
He opened a place.
This guy named Dave Ray.
You all remember Phil Holland, right?
Sure. Yeah. Age 70, and I went to the same camp.
The 50s, 60s, and 70s were the...
his place.
And now it's time for all of us collectively to answer the question, what does Dinkytown mean to us?